The family of the late former senator and former Armed Forces Chief Rodolfo Biazon remembers his legacy on the first night of his wake at the Heritage Memorial Park in Taguig City. His bereaved wife, Monchi Biazon, called him a family man. His son, Muntinlupa Mayor Rufi Biazon, meanwhile highlighted his father's dedication to public service.
I remember him as I remember him to have been honest and faithful to his family, mga ganun. Yun, it's so hard to find a man like that. This noontime, I was alone. So everywhere I look, especially in the den, I really miss him. Very hard to start.
Pagiging ama, no, talagang sacrifice ang pinakita niya sa amin. At ang nakakatuwa doon kasi nung siya ay naging, sa pagiging public official niya, yung sacrifice, hindi lang siya nag-sacrifice for the family, but meron din siyang sacrifice for the country. Kitang-kita naman namin doon yung kanyang dedication sa paglilingkod. No? Nakakataba ng puso, no, yung reaction ng ating mga kababayan sa buhay ng aming ama. Nakabawas doon sa sakit ng damdamin ng pagkawala. At after all, nakita namin may saysay pala talaga lahat sa ibang tao, no, yung mga nagawa niya.
Several colleagues also paid tribute to the late Chief of Staff, and among them, AFP Chief of Staff General Andres Cedino and Army Chief Lieutenant General Romeo Bruno Jr.
Sa interment, meron tayong mga, may mga ceremonies tayo na gagawin, the proper military ceremonies fitting for sa interment ng isang former chief. Yes, that will be part of it.
Biazon's remains will be brought to the Senate for a necrological service and will then be transferred to the Philippine Marines headquarters for the public viewing. His remains are set to be buried at Balibina ng mga Bayani on the 20th. In a message of defiance on the anniversary of Philippine independence, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows the country will never bow down to any external force. He made the pledge amid challenges to the Philippine sovereign rights in its maritime territory. Theo Gutierrez with a full story.
The intermittent monsoon rains did not dampen the commemoration of the country's 125th Independence Day on Monday morning. No less than President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and his family led the flag-raising ceremony at the Rizal Park, which was followed by the traditional offering of a wreath of flowers at the Rizal National Monument. President Marcos Jr. also led the Independence Day parade at the Quirino Grandstand, which was held after 18 years. Members of the Philippine Armed Forces, National Police, government agencies, LGUs, and students took part in the event. In his speech, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said the Philippines will never again be subservient to foreign powers.
The heroes of our liberation would be proud to know that we have thrown off the ominous yoke of domination, never again to be subservient to any external force that directs or determines our destiny. We have stayed the course and adhered to their ideals for our free and independent country, popular, representative, and responsible.
While the president did not specifically mention China, there are ongoing challenges to the Philippines' territorial integrity in the West Philippine Sea. Marcos Jr. added, the Philippines has yet to be considered totally free from poverty.
These are the corrosive political and social conditions that make the nation not as free as we would like to profess and to believe, such as poverty, inadequate economic opportunities, disabling rather than enabling living conditions, inequality, and apathy. We will strive to remove the unfreedoms. We will aim to feed the hungry, free the bound, and banish poverty. Through wise policies, we will foster a highly conducive and enabling environment in which the exercise of true human compassion shall allow for the full development of the Filipino.
Marcos Jr. urged Filipinos to take ownership of the fight that gave birth to the country's independence. He also challenged Filipinos to assert their liberties every day. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
In other news, Vice President Sara Duterte meets with the Crown Prince of Brunei. Duterte says they talked about sports and the contribution of Filipino workers in Brunei. She also invited Prince Haji Al-Mutadi Villa to the Philippines. And Duterte, who is also the concurrent education secretary, is in Brunei to meet with the officials of the Southeast Asian Minister of Education Organization, or CMEO, to examine strategies that could be used to further raise the quality of education in the region. The Philippine Vice President is serving as the head of the CMEO Council. Meanwhile, in Brunei, she witnessed the signing of two vital partnerships between the University of Brunei, Darussalam, and the Philippine Normal University. Overseas employment opportunities were in high demand at an Independence Day job fair held by the Philippine Labor Department. The story from Zen Hernandez.
Job seekers took advantage of the Independence Day holiday to hunt for jobs. Among them is Jamal, who has a degree in education since 2020, but has yet to land a job. He came all the way from Lanao del Norte and was first in line at the Labor Department's job fair in Quezon City.
Nakita ko lang po sa TV Patrol, ma'am, sa balita, ma'am. Mahirap po yung source of income po talaga doon sa Lanao po, ma'am. Oo, sobrang hirap po talaga. Kaya kailangan mo pang dumayo dito para makahanap ka po ng, ano po, ng trabaho po.
1,379 employers offered over 110,000 job vacancies in the Doles Kalayaan Job Fair this year. Most positions came from manufacturing, retail, sales, business process outsourcing, construction, finance, and insurance. The Dole previously said 11% of applicants during job fairs usually get hired on the spot. Among the lucky ones this year are working student Jay Mar, who got hired as a sales clerk, and Jefferson, a factory worker.
Super overwhelming po kasi parang sa maliit po or sa konting experience ko po na meron na ako, natanggap po ako somehow.
Saya po kasi po, ito po may work na po ulit after ilang months po.
But there was a noticeably longer queue of applicants at the booth for overseas jobs. This recruitment agency has job orders for 500 cleaners in Saudi, 150 factory and construction workers in Japan, housekeepers and butchers in Croatia, and sales personnel for Qatar.
Sa ibang bansa ka, doble yung kita mo eh, di ba?
Oo, dito.
Ay, doon kasi, libre lahat. Hindi ka magbayad ng tubig, bahay.
Mahirap po dito, tas mahirap, malaking standard, pero maliit lang yung salary.
Sa ngayon, kasi balikan na naman, wala naman tayong pandemic ngayon. So, we need more for Japan and then Middle East.
Thousands of other job seekers went to the Department of Migrant Workers job fair. Almost 12,000 job orders for positions like nurses, welders, construction workers, and waiters were up for grabs, with the destination a mix of countries from the Middle East, Europe, and Asia.
Dito po ang job fair natin, siguradong lisensyado ang ating mga recruitment agencies.
Although it is clear that Filipinos are being offered attractive salaries overseas, the Labor Department is appealing for job seekers to consider the social cost of being away from family. The Dole is confident as well in the improving employment landscape due to potential investors in the country. According to Secretary Laguesma, he was able to speak personally to a logistics company based in Thailand planning to expand to the Philippines. Budget carrier AirAsia also announced additional investment.
Bumubukas ang ating ekonomiya dahil maging sa manufacturing, meron na pong mga vacancies nakikita, lalo na sa services, no? Retail and services, yung mga production lines natin, and even yung financial, you know, BPO, yung tourism natin, medyo maganda ang nakikita natin na ikang ay pangitain o larawan.
Job seekers, meanwhile, may still apply for all the job vacancies left unfilled from today's job fairs online through the government's employment portal PhilJobNet. The DMW will also launch an online job fair soon. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.